As you reach the teacher-practitioner consciousness, you yourself must know that the God you're talking about is my consciousness. In my consciousness, there is nothing to be influenced or taught or used, no powers to be used, because my consciousness is itself omniscience. It knows my need, and so forth and so on. So that when you understand God as individual consciousness, you will understand why I and my Father are one, and all that the Father hath is mine, because all that God is my consciousness, and my consciousness embodies the Godhood. And as you go back over the writings now, you will see that every book has this and reveals it, but that you cannot understand it until at a certain point in your evolutionary experience, it hits you and you say, oh, whereas before I was blind, now I see. And from then on, you begin to relax. as you reach the teacher-practitioner consciousness, you yourself must know that the God you're talking about is my consciousness. In my consciousness, there is nothing to be influenced or taught or used, no powers to be used, because my consciousness is itself omniscience. It knows my need, and so forth and so on. So that when you understand God as individual consciousness, you will understand why I and my Father are one, and all that the Father hath is mine, because all that God is my consciousness, and my consciousness embodies the Godhood. And as you go back over the writings now, you will see that every book has this and reveals it, but that you cannot understand it until at a certain point in your evolutionary experience it hits you and you say, oh, whereas before I was blind, now I see. And from then on you begin to relax. As you reach the teacher-practitioner consciousness, you yourself must know that the God you're talking about is my consciousness. In my consciousness, there is nothing to be influenced or taught or used, no powers to be used, because my consciousness is itself omniscience. It knows my need, and so forth and so on. So that when you understand God as individual consciousness, you will understand why I and my Father are one, and all that the Father hath is mine, because all that God is my consciousness, and my consciousness embodies the Godhood. And as you go back over the writings now, you will see that every book has this and reveals it, but that you cannot understand it until at a certain point in your evolutionary experience it hits you and you say, oh, whereas before I was blind, now I see. And from then on you begin to relax. as you reach the teacher-practitioner consciousness, you yourself must know that the God you're talking about is my consciousness. In my consciousness, there is nothing to be influenced or taught or used, no powers to be used, because my consciousness is itself omniscience. It knows my need, and so forth and so on. So that when you understand God as individual consciousness, you will understand why I and my Father are one, and all that the Father hath is mine, because all that God is my consciousness, and my consciousness embodies the Godhood. And as you go back over the writings now, you will see that every book has this and reveals it, but that you cannot understand it until at a certain point in your evolutionary experience, it hits you and you say, oh, whereas before I was blind, now I see. And from then on, you begin to relax.